This is an interesting time to have you. The Congressional Budget Office scored the Republican health care bill today after they made some very small changes, and it went from 24 million uninsured to 23 million uninsured. Progress. How do you get this message out to voters that are not Democratic voters that this is a health care plan that is not doing them any favors?
Well, let's be honest. This bill is an unmitigated disaster. In order to provide $600 billion of tax relief to the wealthy, not only are 23 million people going to lose their coverage, but millions of other folks, if you have a pre-existing condition. I met someone today who said, I'm diabetic, and I'm scared to death, Tom. You're out of luck, potentially and probably. If you have substance abuse or if you're someone thinking about having a kid, health insurance companies under this bill can say, nope, that's not covered. The opioid epidemic, you know, it's touched so many corners of America, Seth, and folks are going to lose coverage for those critical services. This is a dumpster fire, and now, we've got to tell the American people that, and all in service of providing a tax cut to the ultra-wealthy. I talked to a friend yesterday, the mother of two kids with special needs. They're both autistic, and Medicaid is their lifesaver. It enables them to keep their children in their neighborhood school. Without it, they may have to institutionalize their children. That's not right. Healthcare should be a right.
It feels
not a
like
privilege.
The Democratic Party can do a very good job now of saying this is what's wrong with that. And again, I understand you're against a lot of negative messaging. It didn't seem like Obamacare was expressed as a positive until this other came and told people what they were losing. Medicare for All seems to be something a lot of House Democrats are moving towards supporting. Obviously, that is a lot easier to explain than this current Republican bill, easier to explain than Obamacare. Do you see the party moving towards Medicare for All as its platform?
Well, listen, I would love to make sure that everybody had access to health care. And Medicare for All was almost enacted in 2009, and we were, frankly, one vote short of doing that. I would love, if I were king for the day, to do something akin to Medicare for All, because Medicare has been a very good program, and it's helped a lot of people. The reality right now is that the Affordable Care Act has been a lifesaver as well. And again, the irony of this, Seth, is that the Affordable Care Act, the structure of it, was actually a brainchild of the Heritage Foundation, which is a conservative think tank, using market forces to provide access to health care. Why? Because Democrats like President Obama, myself, and others who wanted to be, you know, closer to a Medicare for All model, we couldn't get the votes to get that passed. And so we went with this approach, and it's been a lifesaver for so many people. And so right now, you know, while we fight for something even better, the reality right now is, you know, we have to make the case, and we are making the case. And that's why Republicans don't show up to their own town hall meetings, because they know that this bill is an unmitigated catastrophe.
So you are sort of tasked with rebuilding the Democratic Party, which, let's be honest, didn't have a great year. And do you feel like you have the hardest job in politics right now?
Well, you know, we have our moments. You know, you get 50 Democrats in a room, you might have 100 opinions. But that's kind of what I love about the Democratic Party. And I'll tell you,
I just like 50 Democrats with 50 wins would be nice.
Yes. Well, and you know, Seth, I think we have to look a little bit further than just November of 2016, because, you know, we lost 900 seats in state legislatures over the last 8 years. We had 60 senators in 2009, and now we have 48. We had the House majority, and now we don't have it, and the list goes on. And what we have to do and what we're doing is we've got to get back to basics. You know, we've got to make sure that we're building that strong party infrastructure everywhere, in all 50 states and the territories, and that's exactly what we're doing. We've got to lead with our values and articulate what we stand for. We believe that health care is a right for all and not a privilege for a few. We believe that, you know, prosperity should be shared by everyone and not just by a few at the top. We've been fighting for the average person, you know, for the history of this party, and we're going to keep doing that because that's who we are as Democrats. The energy out there is unbelievable. I was in the West Coast last
week. It does strike me that you have this incredible source of energy from this sort of movement, this activist movement.
Amen.
And I do wish you the best of luck in harnessing it. I do want to ask about this, because this guy, and I don't want to, again, belabor the 2016 election, but a lot of talk about superdelegates. The Democratic Party has superdelegates. The Republican Party does not. Can you make the argument that the Democratic primary process is as democratic as the Republican primary process, as long as you have something like superdelegates?
Well, that's the conversation we're having right now. We have a what we call a unity commission, which was established last year, and it's a partnership of folks who, some of whom supported Secretary Clinton, some of whom supported Senator Sanders, and we had our first meeting earlier this month. And our goal is to produce a democratic primary process and an election process that's fair and open to everyone. The superdelegate issue is one of many issues that we're discussing. And frankly, there are people who I have great respect for who are on both sides of that issue. And that's why we brought this together. It's a very open process. Anyone who wants to come and attend can do so. And people have been giving us ideas and suggestions on superdelegates, on whether primaries should be opened or closed, on how we can make sure we get our message out to everyone. Because I believe our values command the support of the majority of the American people, whether it's health care or climate or good jobs or diversity and inclusion. But we've got to get out there and get that message
out. Well, I feel like this is the part of the movie where the Democrats just lost the big boxing match, and now we're in the training montage for the comeback fight.
Amen.
And I'm looking forward to that. But enjoy your training montage, and thank you so much for being here.
Pleasure to be with you.
Tom Perez.